Hey, welcome to our first Learn English short story. Several of you said that you wanted to hear the story to improve your listening and English speaking skills. So in today's lesson, I'm going to tell you the story called Hungry Joe and explain some of the words that you had questions about. And of course, I'll ask you some questions at the end about the story for you to answer. I also want to take a moment and say that I really appreciate all the questions you asked and the feedback you left in the comments. It was very positive and helpful. Like some of these, Lenielson said, yes, now I'm going to improve my English. Thanks so much. You're welcome, Lenielson. Glad you liked it. Marcus said, that's a good idea. I enjoyed reading the short story. I also looked up the words that I didn't know. It's a good way to improve our English. Thanks. You're welcome, Marcus. Glad you like it, and that's a fantastic way to improve your vocabulary. I'm glad you looked up those words. And as a tip to anyone else who doesn't know the words in the story, look them up as well if we don't cover them in this lesson. Felipe said, beautiful idea, David. Nice story. I didn't know these four words, to groan, to squat down, soggy, and rotty. And I have a question. Is Joe a beggar? No, Felipe. Well, actually, I didn't think of him as a beggar, but I just imagine him some guy at home who forgot to do his grocery shopping. But anyways, let's go ahead and take a look at the words you all mentioned. Most of the words are very simple in the story because they're based on words that I teach my students in the very first class. So now that I know what words you didn't know, I can help you learn them now. Just follow along with the slide to see the pictures. Vocabulary lesson. Groan. A sound you make when you are upset or hungry, like in the story, etc. Sample sentence. She groaned when she saw the mess on the floor. I'm so hungry, he groaned. Rosalie actually asked a question here. Actually, she had a suggestion. She says, in my humble opinion, the word groaned was repeated several times. How about he cried out loudly? You're right, Rosalie. It is a synonym of cry out. But since groan was a word that many students aren't familiar with, I used it several times in the story. That way, you can hear it often and familiarize yourself with it. So groan is kind of a sound like, oh, you know, when you're really hungry and you want something to eat, then you just groan. So next word, loudly. Loudly means relatively high volume, is in the opposite of quiet. So you say, the band played loudly, or she screamed loudly. Another word here was soggy. Soggy means that an object is soaked with moisture or liquid. Is in the opposite of crispy, like the cookies were crispy, crunchy, but when you put them in the liquid, they get soggy, like all soft and falling apart. She put the cookies in her milk because she liked to eat them soggy. He wanted to eat some crackers and peanut butter, but they were all soggy. Squat. Squat means to crouch with your knees bent and the back of your thighs touching your heels. They squatted around the fire to keep warm. She squatted because there was no chair to sit on. Trash can, a container in which waste or trash is thrown. She threw the apples in the trash can. He pulled the boxes out of the trash can. And our last word is rot. To decay or waste away due to bacteria and fungus. The bananas rotted before we could eat them. Most of the pears rotted on the tree while we were traveling. Awesome. So now let's go ahead and listen to the actual story. Listen for these vocabulary words. Listen to the story several times until you can retell it in your own words, so you learn the correct pronunciation and reduce your accent in English. So here we go. Hungry Joe. There is a guy named Joe. He is hungry. Joe wants something to eat. He really wants to eat some chocolate, but he doesn't have any chocolate. Joe groans and sits down on a chair. Joe picks up his backpack. He opens the backpack to see if he has some granola bars, but there aren't any granola bars in his backpack. He groans again loudly. He stands up and walks around the table. He walks to the trash can and squats down beside it. He opens the trash can to see if there is anything to eat in there. Joe sees some old cookies in the trash can, but they are all soggy. He also sees some apples in the bottom of the trash can, but they are brown and rotting. Joe doesn't see anything that looks good. He groans again for the third time. Joe is so hungry, he starts to cry. He really wants something to eat, but he doesn't have anything good to eat. Excellent. Now, listen to the questions and try to answer before I give you the answers. This will help you develop fluency in your English speaking. Let's go. Question number one. Who was hungry? Who was hungry? The answer? Some guy named Joe. Question number two. Where does Joe look for a granola bar? Where does Joe look for a granola bar? Hope you aren't cheating and looking at the text here. Answer on your own. The answer, in his backpack. Joe looks for the granola bar in his backpack. Question number three. How does Joe groan the second time? How does Joe groan the second time? The answer? He groans loudly. He groans very loudly because he's really, really hungry. Question number four. Why does Joe squat beside the trash can? Why does Joe squat beside the trash can? The answer? To see if there is anything he can eat. He's looking for something to eat in the trash can to see if someone threw something away that's still edible. Question number five. Are there any good apples in the trash can? Are there any good apples in the trash can? The answer, no. They are all rotten. Joe sees only rotten apples in the bottom of the trash can. The apples are just sitting there and they're rotting. Question number six. What else does Joe find in the trash can? What else does Joe find in the trash can? The answer? Soggy cookies. He saw the apples in there, they were rotting. He saw some cookies, and the cookies are all soggy. Question number 7. Does Joe find anything good to eat in the trash can? Does Joe find anything good to eat in the trash can? Answer is no, he didn't find anything good to eat in the trash can. There was nothing good in the trash can. Question number 8. How many times did Joe groan? How many times did Joe groan? The answer, 3 times. Joe groaned the first time, he groaned the second time, and he groaned the third time. All right, question number 9. Is Joe happy? Is Joe happy? Answer is no, he isn't happy. Joe is not happy at all. He is hungry and he didn't find anything good to eat. Question number 10. When did Joe start to cry? When did Joe start to cry? The answer, after looking all over for some food, but not finding any. Joe looked everywhere. He didn't find anything good to eat, and so he sat down and started to cry. Awesome. Great job. If you weren't able to answer all the questions, no problem. Just keep practicing and improving your English skill, and eventually you'll get there. Of course, we'll have more Learn English short stories coming your way shortly, based on your feedback, of course, like these from the most recent one. Luciani said, how about both, either, and neither? I think that this creates a little mess on how to use these words for us Brazilians. Thanks. Okay, Luciani. We'll try to include those in a soon and upcoming story. Kinda says, I love it. I don't have any questions about any and some, but if possible, I would like to ask if you can explain for us or put some new stories about adverbs, adjectives, and noun clauses. I think that these points of English are very confusing. Okay, Kinda, you got it. We'll try to include those things in upcoming Learn English short stories for you. Junior also said, I think if it was possible to include translations for some expressions to make it easier for learning, it would be wonderful. I think that's an awesome idea, Junior. We'll try to get more expressions in these stories. Also, translations would be really helpful for those who are just starting off. So if anyone wants to send in a translation, we'll choose the best one to include on the site. Of course, I'll only be able to do that in Portuguese. We'll have to find other people from other countries who can translate into other languages. And I'll be busy preparing more short stories for you, which means that I won't have time to find translations for, you know, for a lot of other languages or even be coming up with these on my own. But if anyone wants to volunteer and help out with creating more resources for each of the stories, you're more than welcome to do so. We'll include your resources here, so go ahead. If you'd like to translate the story for practice, and then we'll take a look and help you out with questions you have, and then we'll even choose one of the best ones to include. Also, other resources that you share or provide could be like pictures for the keywords, illustrations, extra information, lessons, and things like that. For example, if you're an artist and would like to draw a cartoon illustration of the story for us to include on the site as well, that would be amazing and helpful for people to understand the stories better. Or even if you're an English teacher and want to create a lesson based on the stories, please feel free to do that and share it with everyone here too. Any ideas that you have that you're willing to help out with will be really beneficial for all the English students here on the site. So I appreciate it and want to say thank you in advance. Well, that's it, y'all. I hope you enjoyed the story, the lesson, as much as I did creating it. So I'll sign off for now. Say bye-bye. God bless you. Y'all have a great day. And until our next Learn English mini-story. Bye-bye.